how's everyone doing? I wanted to let you guys know there's a horror convention in Somerset, New Jersey, which is in my backyard, essentially. It's called Monsters and Robots, and it's going to be this Saturday and this Sunday, and I'm going to be there. So if you want to come talk to me, I'll be checking out the guests and the vendors. And it's called Monsters and Robots. It's got a bunch of cool vehicles. Like, it's got the original 60s Batman Batcopter and the Batmobile. And it's got the Monkees car, too, from the Monkees TV show. And it's got the Munsters Coach. And it also has the DeLorean from Back to the Future and the Ecto-1 from Ghostbusters. So some really cool cinematic vehicles and stuff like that. And as far as the guest list, I'm gonna go ahead and go through it real quick. You've got Sid Haig, who's been around for forever. He did a lot of the Jack Hill and Rob Zombie movies. And you've got Tony Moran, who is one of the three people who played in the original John Carpenter's Halloween. He played the unmasked Michael Myers. Brian Muir, who was the sculptor for Darth Vader, and he also worked on Aliens and a bunch of other stuff too. Robert Mukes from House of a Thousand Corpses, Alex Vincent from Child's Play and Child's Play 2. You've got Mike Quinn, who played Nyan Noob right there. And yeah, there's been so many different pronunciations. I've heard of this, but I'm pretty sure George Lucas said Nyan Noob. So I'm gonna go with that. And Road Warrior, the old wrestler from back in the day. I remember him, I think it was Hawk and Animal. So Animal is going to be there, so that's pretty cool. And I guess if you can take a picture with him, he'll let you put on like the battle gear and stuff, so that's awesome. Butch Patrick, so from, again, from the Munsters, so that's going to be pretty cool. Eddie Munster. And then you've got Dr. Chud, who was a former member of the Misfits, and I'm trying to like remember through here. Let's see, you've got Greg the Hammer Valentine, another wrestler. You've got Steve Savino, who was in the TV show, The Ultimate Toy Hunter. I remember that TV show. I don't know when it comes on, but I love it. And you've got some other people in here, too, Giovanni Rossi. And she, I guess she's a low-budget horror scream queen. You've got Addie Miller, who was like the teddy bear zombie girl from The Walking Dead. Andrew Anderson, and then you got a ton of comic book artists, and you've got Bob Camp, who was one of the artists from Ren and Stimpy. He worked on a bunch of stuff. I think he did Thundercats and Silverhawks as well. Basil Gagos. I've got Jim Steranko, who did a lot of old school Marvel stuff. Eric Freitas, who worked on Judge Dredd, and you've got a bunch of people from the Garbage Pail Kids, original artists from them too. Jay Lynch, John Gregory, a bunch of them. You have a bunch of really interesting looking artists too. James Warhala. So a bunch of cool, Bob Badansky too, who did a lot of different Marvel stuff, but a whole bunch of cool artists. And I like going to these conventions and stuff like that with the vendors, the vendor tables. And there's been a lot more coming to New Jersey, especially Central Jersey. I've been lobbying for a horror convention to come to the Garden State Exhibit Center for so long. That's where it's being held at. And so many of them, you know, I wrote to them specifically, and the promoters and conventions, and they're like, oh, I don't want to step on the toes of the other big conventions in the area. And I'm like, just don't have it on the same day. And finally, there's one coming. So I'm hoping it goes well, because I would love to see this being a reoccurring event here at this location. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say, you know, come out on the 27th and the 28th of August, Saturday and Sunday. There's gonna be different panels as well. I'm really looking forward to the Garbage Pail Kids panel where they talk about it. You know, they have the new documentary coming out as well for it. I don't know if they'll have that at the show or not, but again, tons of different vendors selling stuff. And again, I'm gonna be checking out the different vehicles, which I think is pretty cool. And I'm gonna get a few things signed up. First off, I already have Sid Haig signed up on House of a Thousand Corpses right here. And I don't remember him saying this quote in the movie or on the menu screen as well, but if you can read that right there. But I might get, sorry I haven't signed up on this, I might get Robert Mukes to sign this too. So, love the heck out of this, my favorite Rob Zombie movie. And I am going to get him to, Sid Haig to sign Pit Stop, my Arrow Video Blu-ray release right there. I love the heck out of this movie. Great racing action movie with great dramatic effects. This is back when Sid Haig had hair. Let me see if I can show you real quick. There it is right there in the back. I'm not going to take the booklet out. But yeah, and I was thinking it's the reversible cover. This was the newly commissioned artwork. I don't really like that. It's kind of generic. It is a little bit eye-catching, but this one does have the, characters on there depicted, but I don't love that artwork. But I think it has more like a white background, so the signature will pop a little bit more. So I'm going to go with that cover for Sid Haig to sign up. Great Jack Hill movie. Highly recommend this one if you like racing movies. Black and white. It's from, I want to say 68 maybe? 69? I'm not seeing the year on here right now, but I believe it's one of those two. But yeah, love the heck out of this film. Would highly recommend it. And then I do have a comic book that I just came across this because I know he did Ghost Rider from Badansky. So I'm going to get him to sign this cover. Love the heck out of this cover. It's more of a reader copy. It's a little beat up, but I'm just getting it because the artwork always popped out to me. And I loved comics as a kid growing up, so I'm kind of getting back into them and love that cover artwork. So that'll be awesome getting to sign up on that. And then I was thinking about I was going to get Andy, Alex Vincent, to sign up for Child's Play. I have the Chucky collection, the outer slip box. It just, I don't think it'll look good signed up on that. So I was thinking about maybe getting it signed up on the inner digipack right there, like maybe on the forehead for Chucky. And there's the back right there. So I'm thinking about doing that. Or I do have the Comic-Con exclusive slipcover from 2013, but it kind of, I feel like this is kind of generic. I'm not really loving the cover on that one, but I do love the black case. Initially, I didn't have the movie on Blu-ray, which is why I got it, but I don't know. Let me know what you think. Should I get it signed on that or right there? Because again, I wish this wasn't so kind of like jumbled, because I would have loved to get it signed on the outer slipcase for it. And then, again, Mike Quinn for Nine Numb. I'm gonna get this Funko Pop signed up. This is the GameStop exclusive on the helmet. I like getting the actual figure signed instead of on the case. I know a lot of people put them on the case. And I was gonna get it signed up on this one because I like this one better. But it has ridges on the outside of, or on the top right there for his hat. So it's not gonna really work well for the signature. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this one signed up right here with the fighter pilot helmet. So I think that'll be cool for, you know, again, he was in Force Awakens recently, and I'm looking forward to seeing what they're going to utilize with his character in the future, too. So I actually always liked his character, you know, kind of the pancake face look, but awesome character. So that's what I have for what I'm going to get signed up right now for the people I'm going to meet. I might get other stuff from the vendors, or if they have cool stuff at their tables for the different people. I'm probably going to meet Animal as well for the Road Warriors from back in the day. I remember really being into wrestling back then. I really like them and the Bushwhackers. But yeah, from like the late 80s to like the late 90s I was really big into wrestling. Again, I really liked... I'm going to tell you some of my favorite wrestlers right now. Razor Ramon was like always my favorite. I like Diesel, you know, Scott Hall, Kevin Nash, 123 Kid. So all of them I really enjoyed. I liked a lot of the WCW people too. But I also liked Tatanka, Hillbilly Jim, Junkyard Dog. So back in the day kind of stuff right there. Earthquake too. A bunch of those guys. Coco Beware. But so it's kind of cool to see like some of these older wrestlers doing the convention scene. So yeah, that's what I have when I'm going to get signed up. Let me know what you think about getting the different stuff signed up. I don't know, Sid Haig, it's going to be kind of awesome to talk to him. He's kind of like one of the bigger celebrity names for this one. So I hope next time that they come that they can get a few more big celebrities too, or actors and stuff. But I'm excited. Again, the vendors are going to be awesome. The panel, can't wait to see the Garchpil Kid panel. Butch Patrick's going to be doing one. They're going to be talking about, I think everybody's basically doing panels. They're going to be talking about Star Wars, a bunch of cool stuff. So I'm excited. Monsters and Robots, August 27th and 28th. Check it out. Saturday and Sunday. I believe tickets, if you buy in advance, are I think like $30. And then I think if you buy them at the door, I think it's a few bucks more for the entrance. And then again, of course, you pay for whatever you buy there or get a signature or anything like that. So I'm excited. Again, Somerset, New Jersey at the Garden State Exhibit Center. Check it out. You know, come hang out with me if you're going to be there, you know. And leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think I should get signed up. And I hope everybody's doing well. Take care.